Hi guys, welcome to our new video. Today you're going to learn how to set up a network for an internet cafe. So if you have an internet cafe or if you want to set up one, so this is the way it's gonna work. We want to show you how it works. First of all, you need 1 to 2 computers, and we have a couple of them for now. Then you need what they call a server. A server is any computer you think it's gonna be able to hold or to handle all the software you're gonna use, so that it can manage all these computers. So there's a software for internet cafe, there's handy cafe, there's easy cafe, there's net cafe. Like here there's net cafe, so that's the software you use. But the first thing to do is to set up your network first. So you need maybe 2 computers, 3 computers, 4 computers, and also you need also a server computer. So how does the networking work? So what you do, you get what they call a hub, a switch, whatever you get. Also you can get just a modem, a simple modem which has 2 ports, 3 ports. It depends on what you want to, how many computers you want to run. So here we have a switch, this one. It's a small hub. It's it has approximately 16 ports, this one. You don't need something big. It depends on what you need. So you can run this. After running this, then you put internet here. If you, maybe you're not going to use internet, depends, but most internet cafes, they use internet. So once everything, you put each and every computer on here. I'm gonna show you all of these computers. They are connected here. You can see on this port, on this hub. So you run cables like this. You run this cable, you can see it runs from here and it goes straight to the computer. So but this device helps to supply whatever gonna go inside here, or to connect all computers to be together. That's all. So if you have internet, like here they're using this modem. So since they're using this modem for now, so this modem is the one which has internet. So the internet runs from there, then it goes here. So the modem gives internet here. So then what happens is, like, we take internet from here, because already this device is supplied with the internet access connection. So now we take this cable, connect it here, we run it, and we bring it here in this, we bring it here in this, what you can see, this is the cable, goes and goes and goes, come back and enter here. So it, so now what happens is this cable does supply internet to this. So once it gives internet to this device, so it simply means any computer which is connected here is gonna get internet access. That's all. So this is the first part. Part one is connect all computers on one device. So that device also has something like a power. You get a power, you get these ones. You can, if you don't have money, you can buy on Amazon, you can buy on eBay, you can buy on Alibaba, all those whatever big websites. You can get used ones which are easy to get. This thing is, if even less than $20, you can need it. $10, $20, you get it, you buy it, then you put it here. So you connect it to power, because this is the pin which goes, which the power supply, though it goes until here. You can see it's a D-link, you can see it's a D-link, but you can buy any brand you're looking for, you need, it's okay. Then once this is connected and you connect all your computers, put softwares, you choose which software you want to use. You want to use Handy Cafe, Easy Cafe, Net Cafe, whatever software you want to use. There are many softwares online. Just say internet cafe, what software. So get it free, then you test. But now, once you have your client computers, these are client computers whereby your client's gonna sit. So the main computer is called a server. So and these computers are called what? Client computers. So once you have these connected, also the server has to be connected here. But what we did here, this is the line for the server. So this line also come in here, so that it connects to the network. So this is the network already. So We gave it internet here. We gave it all computers we want them to connect here. They are here. But what we did also, we did run this cable which goes to the server, but it doesn't go straight to the server. There's another hub like this, whereby also this takes internet and the connection, all the connection here, and gives supply that side. You can see it comes from here, then it goes all the way up to the roof. Then I'm gonna take you there where we're gonna see the server, where the server is. Okay. Okay, we are in here. There's also a computer here. It's connected, but this one is a laptop. It's connected to the wireless of that modem. So let's go here. Okay. Also, these machines are connected to the network. How? Via a computer. So now what we do, this is the server here. This is the server computer. Let me get everything right here for you. So this computer, you can see we're running a software called Netcafe. So that Netcafe, you can see it displays all computers here. You get me? This is the server. So you install here what they call the server software for EasyCafe, what they call Netcafe. So that then goes directly, and it sees those computer, whatever computer there you connect, you put that client's what software, it's gonna be seen here. But also you have to set up the IP address. You have to tell those computers good day that the IP address for the server is this kind, is this type. So once you're done with that, so whatever computer you put, whichever computer you put, this is the same software, but the client software, not the server software, is gonna be displayed here. Like here, there's number 10, 11, 12, 9, 8, 7, 6, 3, 1. You get me? So all those computers are on. So simply means all those computers, you can control them from here. You can open number 7, you can open number 3. So if we can see from far, we can open number 3. You can do this. You can maybe sometimes you can double click on piece on the PC you want to connect. Then it will open. Then if you want to close it, you can say also close. You close it. Are you sure you want to close? You close it. Okay, say exit. So you wanna give it time, you can just right click and say timer. Okay, restart. You can restart the computer. You can turn off all computers. You can restart all computers. You understand? So that's the way it works. So this helps you to control, to give people time, how much time they need, and when they pay you, then you take that money and also give them time according to what they have paid. So you can click here and say timer. Then you can put it maybe cash. You can set it to maybe 90. Then enter cash. Then you say okay. Once you say okay, it's gonna do what? It's gonna automatically open that side. So we're gonna close that. Okay, close it. No, let me not close it. I wanna go 90. It gave 90 minutes. You can see. If we close it and we say we're gonna give it 9 minutes. I can see 1 minute, time used 1 minute out of what? So we're gonna close it. Yes, remove from, okay, exit. So what are we gonna do? I'm gonna give it time. I'm gonna give it 5 minutes. Total cash, it's the same thing as mint. I'm gonna go to that computer, then I show you what it's gonna say. So it's very easy to set up this network, and if you want any extra help, you can also contact us or comment in the comment box below. If you have a specific software you want to use, it's also okay, but the network is very easy to set up. So what you do here, you can see this is a computer we did give time. Now we gave it how much? We gave it I think 5 minutes. So I'm here on the computer, so I wanna close all this and I'll see what's going on here. When I click here, it shows 1 minute is gone. Understand? So if my 5 minutes is finished, then the computer is gonna close automatically. You get me? So now I can go to maybe Azania Tutorials YouTube. YouTube.com. No, it went to Yahoo.com. I'm gonna say YouTube. YouTube.com, you enter. Now I can do what? I can go to what Azania tutorials. Okay, Azania tutorials, we get that. Once you get that, then we can play. This was one of the last videos we made, so we're playing this video. Okay, so now what's gonna happen is if I leave this computer and I'm gonna go that side and I close it, I'm gonna do a shortcut. I won't go far reach here, so you can see that's PC what? PC3. If I say close, it's gonna ask me that, then I say okay. But you can see now, let me see, exit. We're gonna go back and we're gonna see it's gonna be closed. You can see now it's closed. So guys, that's the way you do it's simple. It says those are simple steps. You need a hub for the internet. You can buy whatever. I don't know in your country how do you do. You can also use a dongle, a wireless dongle. You some of the hubs, they take USBs. You take a USB inside. Once you connect it to one hub, then it's gonna give everything to, it's gonna supply internet to each and every each and every computer. Guys, thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe. If you have any problem or any question, please talk to us, then we're gonna come back to you. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.